p.m. Central European Summer Time. But pick and bans are underway. Aurelia and Fizz taken away by the Super Hot crew. And there is again Maokai and Yasuo, followed by Elise this time. So they want to force Impaler out of his comfort zone, it seems.
Okay, so no Elise for him. He didn't use it as effective as Jankers normally uses Elise, but still managed to be a part of a lot of the early game fights. And always was there with his Spectral Waves as the first item to burst people down. Which did work out pretty well for Super crew in the early stages, especially Selfie. Managed to get a few kills together with Impaler. I wonder here, Alistar is open for Super crew. Mimer did have a good Alistar game in game one. Kevin had a horrible one in game two. So I'm not sure if it's still first pick worthy. Also because we have seen certain champions like Lulu, like Zac, work against the Alistar now.
And it seems that they are happy. They're going to let see what they choose in that top lane, try and counter it again maybe, pull out the Zac once again, who knows. Morgana locked in for Kasing, he's played it in the last two games with great success. There is the Alistar locked in instantly for Kevin, or is it Jayree? Who knows? Cogmore picked up by Kreaton, they're going to take that away from Mr. Rollers.
I'm already wrong in my prediction about Ezreal Blitzcrank, which is the famous Kreaton and Jayree lane when they are desperate for wins. So taking him still away from Mr. Alice, who played it the last two games, who's actually just been doing everything he could and just been picking up kills left and right in his teamfights, because Millennium could never get to him in either game one or game two, so smart enough to take it away. And funny thing is, Millennium is doing the same they did against SK now. They lose the first two games and then they suddenly change up, especially the AD carry pick, where it was Lucian Corki in the first two games against SK Gaming. Now they change it up, take away the other team's AD carry. But they have to wait a few games where they lose first before they do it. And if it's enough, we'll have to see.
Super Hot crew currently hovering over Tristana, who again has been pretty much the dominant AD carry. What about Vi there briefly for Impaler? Was a champion that we saw, of course, the Turkish team Dark Passage playing their final matchup to great success. But it's going to be Jarvan. Jarvan, that fullback champion, or strongly rising to be pretty much the main choice in the jungle these days.
At least getting stronger and stronger with all the nerfs to the other junglers around him. And always a good champion against AD carries who has no gap close, who has no jump. Because if there's no flash, you can just hold onto him and he's locked in there and you can then focus him down. It's always a nice pickup in that case. And also if Orianna gets locked in, same deal. You have no jumps on your mid lane now. So two nice targets for Impaler, which he can engage on, especially if Subaku do get a lead and can start forcing these fights. They have the Morgana, of course, for Kasing, been a strong pick all around. Also making it even harder for Kevin to single target engage. He can still, of course, go in and get multiple people up in the air, but that becomes harder and harder for him to do. And you already have just a little bit of pick potential with the Morgana.
Orianna locked in for Kerb.
Wow.
This time around.
Didn't actually know he played it.
We'll see where it works out for him. Assassins haven't worked. We'll see whether he manages to go with a farm heavy champion this time around and try and win out that mid lane.
And look at what Millennium is actually doing now. They're saying, we have tried our pick comps. It didn't work. We have lost the games. Now we're going to try and join the team fighting train and see if that can carry us and if that can actually make sure we get a win and we can then at least get one more chance, secure a potential fifth game and also keep their spot in the LCS. So Millennium completely changing up their style now compared to what we normally see from them by going more teamfight focus. And again, Orianna was banned in every single game by Millennium against SK Gaming in the quarterfinals. So I didn't expect Kerb to actually play it. Really looking forward to see what he can actually do on it against Selfie.
But look at this, the fullback champion, Ahri, comes out for Selfie. They forgot about that one, didn't they? MVP in week 10. On Ahri, two solid, solid games for him in that one. And Kasing once again selecting Zac for Mimer in that top lane. Again, Jayree.
I mean, it could be Alistar support still if they once again want to dodge around with Zac, who clearly had the upper hand in the one-on-one against Alistar in the last game. So it could be support Alistar and top lane Shen.
If I was a body language
not
expert.
Not that Shen is working better against Zac.
If I was a body language expert looking at Jayree right now, this would tell me a lot. He's a slump down in that chair. He is going to be playing Alistar, so it's going to actually be Shen in that top lane up against Zac. And Jayree will take Alistar, a champion that didn't work too well in support last time around.
No, lost two games against SK.
For Legacy, though.
It did, but so Millennium again, putting a lot more focus now on the team fights. You do have the Shen to create some split pushing pressure, but there's teleport on Mimer, and Zac has always been, or used to be, a very good pick against Shen because he couldn't, again, he couldn't touch you in lane. You out sustain him, you out push him, and you have the teleport to stay there. And if Kevin runs without the teleport here, I feel like it's a big mistake. If he does have teleport, they have this now double global advantage they can use against Mimer. So if he jumps down first with his ult and Mimer TP's after him, you will now have to teleport for next time around, and therefore you can create some pressure. Seems like he's actually not going to run it, which means he's losing out, in my opinion, on a lot of the global pressure, but we'll have more lane pressure instead against Mimer.
Well, who do you guys at home looks the strongest heading into this game three? Will it be the Super Hawk crew? Will they take it clean sweep? Hashtag SHC win or hashtag MIL win to at LOL Esports, and we'll be checking the results shortly as the game gets underway. Will it be a 3-0 once again in this best of five?
Again, looking at the last two games, Super Hawk crew has clearly been the best team. They've been able to punish Millennium for whatever mistake they made. And Millennium has not been able to do the same to Super Hawk crew in any of the games, especially not in the last one.
Well, here we go. Will it be the last game, ladies and gentlemen? Game three underway as the Super Hawk crew will be starting out on the blue side up against Millennium on the red here live at Gamescom. It's Hall 8, if you're wondering, and you're coming to Gamescom soon. We have a gigantic stage and arena set up for you guys. It is possibly the biggest thing I've seen at Gamescom in a few years, and this is my fourth year here. Super Hawk crew starting out so strong in this best of five series. Will they take it all the way?
Let's see up in this top lane here. I mean, again, Millennium lane swap last time around because they didn't want to have Alistar against Zac, and they didn't want to have the Leona against the Morgana down the bottom lane, so they swapped around, which made a lot of sense. They just played it horribly wrong, gave up early dragon, gave up early kills. We keep talking about it. In this game here, Kevin should actually be able to hold his own now, at least in the start, due to the fact he doesn't have teleport and Mimer does have teleport, so there's a summoner spell advantage for Kevin up in the top lane. Mid lane, Curb needs to show what he can do on his Orianna. One of the first times again I've seen him play it.
Let's see how it works out for them. Warding is going well. We do see, of course, down the bottom as well that Kraton and Jayria trying to get some deep vision, just hanging around, waiting to get that ward placed just at the right time, because of course it will time out fairly fast with these trinkets. Jay Reese is off cooldown, so it's Kraton that has to place it. So he's got a ward. No, he doesn't have a ward in his bag. So just simply using standard vision, and actually Lee Sin is going to come around. So they're going to start off that one. They're not going to rotate round. It is going to be 2v1 lanes.
Yeah, Subaru, this time around, the team choose to start the lane swap. Also simply because they want to see if they can punish Millennium once again. We will have the dragon advantage for Millennium now, where they're down in the bottom lane with their dual lane. But let's see if Subaru actually wants to send down Kissing, have him together with Impaler and Mimer to move into the dragon if Millennium started early on and just interrupted. Because you take so much damage from it, you can't just stand there if three members collapse onto you.
Well, Kevin's actually going on the raids, so he's going to be soloing those. Jayri uses his presence to try to bully them away, but he got vision, knows that they started on the red, knows that that's a clean wave, and he's going to go down the bottom. It does give the AD carry some free time. Let's see if either of them push up. Right now it seems they're going to both happily freeze the lane. Not going to shove it into the tower, so it's kind of doesn't really give an advantage to either of them. They're, I think, both happy to just 2v1 this lane out.
2v0 even. Just freeze the lane for now. Make sure the top laners are forced to run at the jungler around to pick up farm. And then you can decide from there on. I mean, again, if Millennium keeps freezing the bottom lane, they can't really go dragon, because then they lose a lot of farm if Kraton moves to the dragon. So in that case, it's good for Super Crew that Millennium is actually freezing it. And we also do see Mimer and Impaler looking for Cotton X and Kevin here. Make sure they know where they are, and make sure they're not going for an early dragon.
Yeah, they have that top area covered. Check out the golems. Notice that they are there, but they're not going to follow on through. There's nothing for them to dive into. The one problem with this is that they could set up Millennium to take an early dragon, which it looks like they may well be maneuvering to do.
There's a double recall. Kassing is running from base towards the dragon here, so Subaru would want to leave Mr. Rylus to just freeze the top lane all alone. But they're going to be too far away from this dragon here, so even though they were actually running around looking for Kevin and Kotnex, they decided to recall and are now too far away to actually stop this one, so Millennium should be able to pick up this dragon.
Yeah, it's going to be a slow one, of course, at this low level, but Impaler's not heading this way, he's simply going towards the Wraith, so Millennium starting off with the dragon. It's always the trade that you pretty much aware that you're going to lose out on when you give up this bottom lane.
Yes and no. You don't have to give up the dragon. You can send your support, your jungler,
you
in the top.
You need somebody to just go there, and they basically puts the threat margin down, and
exactly,
they would generally back away from it.
You don't have to give up the dragon. We actually saw a lot of teams stop even trying to start the dragon because they just expected the other team to be nearby with two or three members to stop them anyway. So they just stayed in the jungle to farm because it became like the way to counter the fact that, okay, there are two people down this bottom lane, they have the dragon advantage. Nope, not anymore, because we send down our support to help. Because you don't need Kassane to stay in the top lane for such a long time to just sit there. Yeah, sure, he wants the XP, but you don't need him because Mr. Rylas has been freezing the lane non-stop. So why did you have your support sitting there instead of being around this dragon here to stop it, so Millennium couldn't pick it up? Because Millennium didn't lose anything from taking the dragon. They just walked in, killed it. I'm pretty sure Kraton even stayed in the bottom lane, didn't even move from it. So Subaku should have been there to stop it.
Well, farming-wise in the mid lane, they have, of course, had free time together. Kirpan, Selfie, Kirp build himself up a bit of an advantage. Not a great deal, but it's a small one. That should probably balance itself out, because at the moment Kirp's got next to no mana. Impaler wards down. He's going to slide across, it seems, and try and get around the back of Kevin. Bide his time in this bush, wait for everything to come off cooldown. This could be the first 3v1 dive we see for the support crew.
There's only level 2 on Kevin here. He does have his dash to dodge the flag from Impaler, flag and drag. The thing joining in too, but now Kotnex is nearby, so it's going to make it a bit of a risky dive.
Well, instead, they may well go for him, because Sing does the ward. They get vision, they know that he's there now. Now it's going to be a dangerous move. Now it'll actually be a 3v3, because Jayree's heading up here as well. Instead, it's just going to turn into invade. Impaler coming around the side, they're still
TP from Mimer.
Not sure if they're fancy it, they are. They're going to TP in. Mimer comes around the side there. This is all on the tower right now, except Tony hipping the minions. Jayree taken low. Nobody takes a tower hit just yet because the tower is still firing at the minions. They haven't drawn aggro. Now they've got to play this one just about perfect. Darkbinding catches on Jayree. He's going to be the focus. Dragon strike on from Impaler. Puts down his Demacia standard but does not go any deeper. Now look at this. Selfie joining the party. Five members of Super Haku in here. They really want to make it count. Jayree's going to go down.
It.
First blood in there. Kotnex focused on. He's going to get taken down. The ignite on him. They're going to get the cell division out, and he's going to be, I'm just going to be safe from this one. The tower is targeting the cell division, but I don't think he's going to finish it off. Mr. Rales, is he going to survive? Yes, he will. Mimer comes back out. Kasing's got two tower hits, but he's safe. And they get all three kills for one in the top lane.
And Kirp was just sitting in the mid lane while Selfie walked from mid lane to the top lane, joined in with his team here. It's all about Zac because he can tank the tower first, get his passive proc when he actually dies, and then reset the tower so he won't die anyway. And Super can just stay here, wait for Selfie. Five members down the bottom lane, Kraton is sitting, freezing the lane. In the mid lane, Kirp is not moving, he's just sitting there farming. So Super had so much time to just set up this dive in the top lane. Millennium could see it all along. They knew it was going to happen. As soon as they saw the TP from Mimer, the guy didn't even base first. He just TP'd from the bottom lane. As soon as the wave was being frozen by Kraton, he TP'd to the top lane. He wanted to go for the dive like they did in the last game with the Zac. Same deal. He's going in, tank up most of the damage, passive procs, and they pick up the kills again. Yes, they lost Impaler this time around. They didn't lose anyone last time. But just no reaction from Millennium at all. They just sit on the tower. Don't even move away. Don't even say, okay. We know you're going to dive us now. We know you have Zac. Let's just back away from this tower. Kraton can then either push it down this bottom lane. We can try and rotate it down. And then we traded the dragon we got earlier for the tower you get in this top lane. Instead of staying, with Kirp also staying in the mid lane and knowing, okay, now it's going to be 5v3. There's a high chance we die. They stay under the tower.
I just wonder whether it's simply a case of they've not played against Zac in that long. They forgot that, of course, he could tank it. He could use his passive and just be safe.
Maybe.
Of course, you guys at home voting 79%. It is just flickering back to 76. So a couple of Millennium fans out there, but not too many of you. And Super Hot Crew are looking solid. But going back to your point, I mean, it's just whether they just thought, I mean, let's face it, they had a Shen. They could have taunted. They did. They managed to get a couple of hits in there. They got an Elise in, pretty strong. They had an Alistar. Good CC. So maybe they just thought, we can take it. 5v3, yeah, no problem on the tap.
They probably did. They probably felt confident saying, we are ready if you do divers. I'm not sure if they expected Selfie to show up and suddenly be five members, but it seemed like they were just staying confident saying, we can handle this. Instead of just playing safe and you're four, potentially five members very soon, we're just going to back away from this tower here. We're not going to take the chance. We already got the dragon. We're happy to take the trade. Meanwhile, our AD carry is just in this bottom lane farming. Our mid lane is just sitting in the mid lane farming, getting a CS advantage as well. We take it, you get the tower. Nope, stay under and end up dying.
They're going to focus on Miami. No, not got cell division available. Instead, he uses less bounce to escape here. Is he going to get caught out? He is. Connex, though, taking a couple of tower hits. Bimer Impaler is nearby, but he's not close enough to get involved and get the kill.
Good setup, though. Shame with the taunt. No patch from Miami used before, and Connex can actually pick up a kill. So we're back to standard lanes. Kevin should be able to even out the CS. He push it into the tower as well. He does have his ulti. There's no TP in Mimer, so Millennium can set up a play in the bottom lane if they do want. And there's also Dragon spawning in about 15 seconds, where once again Mimer won't have his teleport. So this should mean Millennium has to pick up this Dragon, as there can be potentially five members to only the four of Subaru, because Mimer's going to return to the top lane.
Mimer goes up. As you mentioned, the ultimate. It's been a while since we saw Shen. He's been sitting in the band cabinet for a while. He has got himself out of there, but hasn't had a great deal of use. We'll see how it works out for him as this game progresses with Kevin. He was a champion he was very, very good on back in 2013. He used to play it fairly heavily back in the days of Warmox. Thank God they're gone, that's for sure. But Selfie in his mid lane on Ahri, as you mentioned, probably surprised him when he turned up. Maybe Kerb didn't give the call. Maybe he did. Who knows? We can't tell. Charm lands, though. Kerb's going to dodge around there. Soul Shackle's not enough. Tries to pull the ball in, but wasn't expecting the Cataclysm. And that was a clean kill for the support crew in a 3v1.
And just pushing straight onto the tower here. Kotnix is going to join in. Jiri is going to be there trying to defend. Kevin. He taunted Mime up in his top lane. Got him very low, and now chasing for the kill.
Cell division is not available, I don't think. Still on cooldown. Mimer's in trouble here. He's got the ignite down. He might well go down. Kevin's going to get caught in the tower.
Just
the knockup is just about enough. Manages to catch on towards that last hit. Selfie will take down this middle turret. The first one of the game for the support crew.
So just one kill on Kerb in the mid lane, and instantly they move in for the tower. Managed to get it here. And two members now. Dragon is alive. Running in towards it. Well, maybe they want to dive Kresson down this bottom lane and just want to get some deep wards. Actually, just went back on my screen here to see the dive once again. Selfie was pinged by Millennium the entire way from mid lane to top lane because there was a ward on him, and yet they just stayed on the tower. So they knew he was coming. It wasn't about like, oh my god, Selfie's here.
Interesting, interesting play. Three members pushing down the bottom lane. Let's see if they can take a 3v2. Maybe you're going to turn into a 4v3 in favor of Millennium. This Kerb is starting to head down, but he's going to stop in the river. He's going to back away. Kotnex was just waiting off at the side. Instead, they will return back to that mid lane.
Kresson is doing a pretty good job farming down this bottom lane here, and Millennium really needs him to go huge this game so they can protect him in these team fights, and he can be the carry in the late game. Mr. Riles, however, picked up two kills while, of course, Kresson was just sitting in the bottom lane freezing when we had all the action in the top lane. With the mid tower gone, you also see instantly Subaru just placing a ward where the tower actually was, and it's one of the reasons the mid tower is so important, because now you have a ward where you can see the entrance to the jungle from the mid lane for Millennium, so they can spot whoever is moving between the lanes very easily, and just makes it so more safe for them to take like the push that they did down here in the bottom lane, because they knew, okay, we haven't spotted, or we saw Kerb, sorry, moving from the mid lane, so we know he's not even close to this tower. We can just push up three members and take it.
And if you look down towards the blue buff area, you can see there's a lot of ward coverage, super hot crew, full vision, able to just siege out, take that bottom turret. So now 2-0 up in turrets, given a small advantage across the board. Selfie ahead in CS. Mr. Rollins is behind in CS, but he's got that 2-0-1 from the five-man tower dive. Rabadon's, Deathfire Grasp completed as first item for Selfie as well. So he's gonna start looking to blow people up, and Kraton is an ideal target when it comes to the team fights. If you can latch onto him, he will go down very quickly, and Kevin's going to have to be pretty hot on that ultimate to try and save him.
And we do see up in his top lane here, even though they had to gang onto Mimer where they killed him, and then Kevin actually forced him back again because he taunted him under the tower and then chased him. Mimer is just farming as much as you want. He can just constantly push in the wave, force Kevin to sit under his own tower, and therefore make it even harder for him to actually use his ulti. Because if you do, well, high chance your top tower will die, and if you don't get anything from the kill, or from the ulti, suddenly you lose out on a lot of gold. So Mimer just minding his own business up in his top lane, pushing it down, ignoring Kevin every time he can. Actually, just ignoring him all the time.
Completely ignoring him. Dragon back up. Nobody really making moves towards it just yet. Jayri being held back by Kasing, wants to fight for the pink ward. Smack, trust me, the support battle for the pink wards is real. It's a thing. And these guys hate losing out on them pink wards because that's a lot of gold they have to invest when they don't get too much themselves.
I feel like it was a little bit of an unfair fight, however, as Impaler and Selfie moved in to help Kasing. Does look like Super Crew want to set up for a fight here. Do have teleport. It does have teleport on Mimer. There's not a ward behind Millennium, however, so he's gonna have to teleport around the dragon if he wants to join in. Now there's a ward behind him. Could be the one Mimer wants to join in. But now he's just pushing the lane. Actually gonna run down, see if he can save his own teleport if they do manage to stall Millennium long enough. And seeing as Millennium is not really pushing for the dragon themselves, it just opens up for Super Crew now to push in this mid lane. Get a few hits on it, and force Millennium also to move away from the dragon area.
Four pink wards from the support crew in that river right now. Definitely got good coverage, that's for sure. We can set up for that dragon. Putting the pressure on towards Millennium forces them to cover and defend the mid lane. Support crew can just rotate down. Pings are down there. Mr. Ryan's already heading down towards the dragon. Start things off. They can see that one ward in the river that Millennium have. That's going to get cleared out. They can't see that one, but it is about to time out. No, we can't. Can't see either of them.
Just
ping wards just
inside
out of range.
The pit there, yeah. So you can actually see it. This Mina over there is a ward outside, which Kasing will now clear because the sword had their own ward to see it being placed. Otherwise, there was a ward to see if Subaru actually started the dragon, which was the whole idea behind it from Millennium. It is now gone, and there's full river control except for one ward for Subaru here. And they did invest a lot of gold in these ping wards, so they do have to pick up the dragon for it to be worth it.
Mimer and Kevin continue their brawl in the top lane. Holding the tower strong right now, but with them, there goes the dragon. Simply took down between Mr. Ralas and Impaler. They didn't need the team there. Tower down. So, bottom wave, is actually pushed in pretty well here. They could get some damage down onto the inner, and it's only Kraton reacting. It's going to be a 2v1 for a short period of time. Mimer and Kevin still slogging back and forth in this top lane. Nothing really landing. That tower very low now. Millennium, they're going to lose all 3 outers very shortly.
Yeah, again, one teleport from Kevin and the tower is gone. Even the minion can just kill it themselves. And just again, once again, look down around this dragon. It's fully warded by Super Crew. It meant they can take the dragon, 2 members only. And we always talk about how Tristana has the weak mid game. Well, if you have so much control in the map here and you already have the goal lead, it doesn't even matter because then you can just go in with Tristana anyway. And it's going to be completely uncontested because Millennium didn't want to try and face check Super Hot Crew here. Which meant the dragon, now the top tower as well. And once again, Super Crew from the lane drop, they started it this time because they knew, okay, there's a very high chance Millennium will make a mistake again in this lane swap. And we just saw the aggressive teleport from Mimer up in the top and didn't even go back to base first, just straight up teleport top lane, Selfie moving up and went for the dive against 3 members again, like they did in the last game. And Millennium tried to do the exact same. Let's stay on the tower. Okay, now we died.
So Super Crew dominant throughout this best of five so far. 2-0 up, can they make it a solid clean sweep 3-0? We saw the Turkish team Dark Passage doing that against Legacy Esports earlier on today, if you missed it. They've secured themselves a spot at the World Championships coming in as one of the international wildcard seeds. They will be in, I think it's seed 3. Is it classed as in the World Championship group stage? It was those two that were down there, I do recall. Along with North America and the European number 3 seeds. We'll see who joins them. And of course, that World Cup stage. It's going to be so big, the groups, when we get to them. They are all ever approaching, honestly. We'll see who gets there from Europe. The semi-finals will be taking part tomorrow. Of course, the 2 finalists instantly will be through there. Number 1 seed is a big, big deal, of course. Getting that number 1 seed for Europe. Number 2, well, you end up in the pot with a whole heap of teams and you no idea where you're going to end up.
2 teams from Korea, 2 teams from China. I mean, you really want to get the number 1 seed here from Europe.
It's a big deal. That's all happening tomorrow. Remember, starting off 11 a.m. Central European Summer Time. I think that's something like 2 a.m. Pacific, so apologies to the North American fans. We are live at a trade fair, so times are kind of out of our hands as to as and when things go, so which is why we are earlier than our ordinary allotted LCS showtime. Also does mean we are live in front of a gigantic audience here at Gamescom. We are sat watching this rather slow start from both teams once again, but Super Hot Crew, honestly, don't seem able to counteract with anything.
No, again, also look at the wards on the map. It's just blue wards everywhere in the jungle, around the blue buff, around the red buff. There's no wards for Millennium, except for one around the Wraith camp that they can actually use to try and spot Super Hot Crew moving around, and that's about it. Which simply means Super Hot Crew is free to move between the lanes, push them in, and get some hits on the tower.
The irony is that the pink wards, they've got five on the map, all five of them. They had two others around the dragon. They're now gone purely because they had to play some deeper. They weren't taken out. They just had to keep on going. Super Hot Crew, full vision of what is going on in Millennium. Kerb's got to be careful he doesn't get caught with a dark binding here. Because Singh waiting off at the side, as is Mimer. Could get the elastic slingshot. He's going to go in. Black Shield went on him. Holds fire, does not jump in. Flash was used by Mr. Rales. Think Kurt may well have got that attack ball on him and he was fearful of a shockwave.
No, his Kotex actually jumping in, I believe, and then he didn't want to risk him safeguarding behind and kick him back. He just instant flashed away, which also means now Subaku might just chill for a few minutes until the flash is ready for Mr. Rylas again, which opens up now for Millennium to push down.
Yeah, this is a mistake. Millennium finally get themselves their first turret of the game, and it is going to be the middle one opening up. Will they be able to follow through? Only Kasing is here right now. Finally, Selfie and Impaler are coming around the sides. They're going to come in. Go aggressive. Wow! The damage on towards him. Kerb gets caught out straight away. Not enough damage to Ignite going down. Kevin has to use his stand United to try and join him. But Millennium, so much damage.
Look at Mimer's TP.
Mimer going in above them. He's got his elastic slingshot available. Will he catch on towards them? Let's bounce. He's in there. Is he going to launch it? No! Holds the trigger.
There was a ward, so the tower actually started shooting at him. And Millennium knew he was about to jump. Therefore, he decided to cancel it. Still managed to pick up a kill on Kotnex with only three members in the mid lane. It's just a binding land from Kasing. And then Selfie went aggressive, killed it. Kevin couldn't even ult in time. Like, Kotnex just instantly died. DFG, everything was used onto him. Still, though, Super Group, because they decided to split up in all the lanes, just completely left the mid lane alone. And Millennium did manage to pick up a tower, which is much needed for them. The first one of the game. Dragon spawning in about 30 seconds. With the control we have seen from Super Hot Crew so far around this dragon area, it should be theirs again. And also because you can't walk in and face check an Ahri with a DFG. Like, you will instant die. So unless Millennium walks straight into this dragon area after the mid tower to play some wards, which is what they should have done and not push down for the next tower. They should have walked into dragon after killing mid tower, get the wards they need, clear the pink wards, which are already there from Super Hot Crew. Then they could actually start setting up and possibly look for a team fight where they don't have to face check a DFG Ahri.
Well, Dragon is now up and Millennium are looking to maybe try and engage on this one. No ultimate available for Kevin, remember. No ultimate available for Jayri either, in fact. While Super Hot Crew have everything off cooldown. Dragon started out. Super Hot Crew fancy this.
Kotnex going in.
China doesn't land. Kotnex gets in and gets out with a safeguard. Selfie goes in. Shockwave pulled in from Jayri. Kotnex will go down from this one. You can see the Cataclysm finishes him off. Dark Binding stepped aside there. Kerb, Stan United. Not going to be enough. Mimer, let's bounce in on towards the Millennium. Soul Shackles will ping off. Kevin gets caught out in that one. As we see, Mr. Rales coming in to clean up. Gets the reset. Gets on towards another. Speeded up by the heel. He tries to chase down Kreaton, will get forced away. They can take anything they want from this one as three members of a Millennium went down for the smite on Dragon.
Yeah, so Millennium actually managed to at least get in towards the Dragon here. They got the smite from Kotnex, but now Subaku can just engage onto them. And because Kerb is on the wrong side here compared to the rest of the team, he's going to be singled out by Subaku. They're just going to chase him down. Nice flash in and ulti from Mimer to knock him up as well. And he's completely separated from the rest of his team. He has to stay with Kreaton in this team fight to help him, and they need to help each other kill these targets here. Instead, though, they split up. Easy for Super Crew to finish up some kills. Mr. Rylas actually didn't get assist here on the last one, so couldn't jump and try and kill Kreaton. Once again, There is full wall control from Suwaku around this dragon here. They're in a good position to start the fight. Yes, okay, they lost the dragon. Was a mistake, connect with a nice steal. But then soon after, they just jump onto Millennium. They split up again, Kraton and Curb, split up from each other. Easy to just single them out.
So, Mr. Wallace clearing out. Static Shiv now on towards that Infinity Edge. Able to clearly wipe out the waves and force them back. Dark Binding lands on Jayree. Impaler not choosing to follow up. They've got a little bit too many Millennium members there. They're going to actually dive in towards it. Black Shield, not going to be enough because Sync caught out. Dark Binding goes down, but look at that. Curb just gets wrecked. Mr. Rallis from the side. They focused everything on that support. And Mr. Rallis free farming at the side, pulling the hits down. The explosive shot enough, followed by the Buster shot, just blows Kevin away. And it's another 3-0. They focused everything on Kassim.
Well, the thing is, Millennium has now hit the point of hit the last two games where they fall so far behind. They feel like they just have to try and make a play. So they go onto the support. Kassim stays alive, lands a perfect binding. Credit to him. Onto Kirby. And Mr. Rallis is standing behind the wall, smacking him, killing him very easily. He dies. Rest of the team joins in. Selfie kill Connex in the mid lane as well. Mimo here.
What?
Let's see what he can do.
What are they doing? Their tower is down. Jayree's like, I got my ulti, guys. Don't worry, I got this. They could not even pick up that kill. Kraton trying to keep them back, doing what they can to defend it. They might try and catch on to Mimo. Connex is going for it. Has to use Let's Bounce to get out of there. Cell Division was not available, and Kraton does get a kill. Can they push on through? Baron is still available. They may try and force something out of nothing here.
Well, Kevin did actually use his ulti here to join in, but Connex was just not in a position. Got knocked back, I believe, actually. Or shot back by... What happened? No, it was Mimo knocked him back just before he died in the very end, so Kevin couldn't actually come in with the taunt. Kevin already went down anyway. Impaler may be looking to set him up. He's
Cataclysm
being pinged, though, by Millennium. They're pinging he's around this area, so they know he's there.
Problem is, the delay's been long enough that Selfie is back. He's got himself his ultimate available. Mr. Rallis kicked on. Flashes and Rocky jumps out of there. Connex now going to get locked up. Mr. Rallis may well go down to the Ignite. Kevin will manage to get the shutdown on him, but only just. Kraton focused out. Selfie blows him apart. Kassim gets himself a kill on Kevin. And there goes Kraton, his passive finally exploding. And again, a 3-1 to Super Arc Crew.
Yeah, and it's just Super Arc Crew sitting on the side here. There's no wards for Millennium if you look down towards the red buff of Super Arc Crew. So they didn't know where Selfie was. He jumped in from the side here. And that was actually also Millennium engaging onto Mr. Rallis. We're just going to see Connex going in, wants to kick him back here. Mr. Rallis actually does take a lot of damage, but will end up dying in the very end as well. Ignite coming in from Kevin to kill him. Kassim with a nice ulti. And now notice here Selfie jumping in from the side. There's no wards from Millennium. They're pushing down the tower. No wards. And there's super fed Ahri coming in from the side, flanking around together with Impaler. Means that Suboku can take the fight even though Kassim wasn't there. Oh, sorry, not Kassim. Mimo wasn't there in the start.
Well, we honestly gave a lot of flack to Impaler, I think it was, throughout the Rockout game. Has played very well. And again, just close to 100%, 98% involvement. Impaler slides in, tries to smite that one away. I think he did get it as well. Yes, he did. Connex didn't smite it in time. And Millennium are on the retreat once again. Didn't quite get super minions though, because the Impaler, they held out, kept the inhibitor away. Elastic slingshot used by Mimer, tried to focus on Kurt, but he's forced back. The rest of the Super Hot crew here in force. As Millennium, they've got a good wave clear now though. They should hold strong unless somebody gets caught once again.
Mimo on this Zac once again, he's just doing whatever he wants to do. He probably picked it against the Alistar, expecting it to be Alistar top lane again.
Yep.
But then once Shen was locked in, which again is a good matchup for Zac, because you can do the exact same, you just push down the wave all the time, he can't really kill you. You saw Kevin almost kill him once again because he taunted him under the tower at like level 5, so he took so much damage from it. But as soon as Mimo got his Spirit's Visage, Kevin couldn't touch him because the magic damage from the Q from Kevin couldn't do anything to him. And it meant Mimo once again in these team fights can be so annoying. Get all the tank items, get his magic pin now as well. And while Kevin also, because he didn't run teleport, there was no global advantage either for Millennium. And Shen is forced to just come in with the team. He can't TP behind them and like flank them because he's only relying on his ulti, which has to be used on, of course, a member from his team. So the Shen pick just ended up not working out for Kevin. Yet, now that 10,000 gold behind, or 9,500. And Super Arc Crew in full control.
solid control. Top lane goes down. Another inner turret used, and Super Hot Crew continue just to play this one cautiously. They're going to rotate around. Mr. Riles will wipe out this wave alongside Impaler. No push available for Millennium. Dragon is up. Will Millennium try to fight?
So Jireem moved down, placed one ward here in the entrance to the river around the dragon, hoping at least now that Millennium maybe can take it. They did just get the bot tower here, so got some gold. But now the rest of Super Crew is moving into this dragon. The wards have been placed by Jireem. Kevin does have ulti up in his top lane. Well, one ward was placed. That's going to be cleared pretty easily. And now we once again have the situation where there is no wards from Millennium here. Full control from Subaku can take it. Millennium is just going to move away, get the dragon. And now Subaku just needs to take the pink wards, move them to Baron, and do the exact same deal. Set them up here, deny all the vision from Millennium, and then put them in a situation where either you're going to face check our DFG very, very fit Ahri or our Zac jumping into you, or you're just going to give us a Baron.
They're just going to focus, I think, the bottom turret, actually. Well, that's where Mr. Rollers was going. Instead, he's decided, the call has said, let's just actually get this Explosive Inhibitor finally down. I think that's where they're going to go.
Probably
Selfie's
start.
Just going to get the blue buff, so they're going to wait for him. I don't think they're going to go too deep. No, it is going to be the bottom turret after all. Just thinking there's a big wave coming in there. They might want to make use of it. Kevin's trying to shove out that top wave and get on towards maybe taking down that top outer turret.
We do at least have some good wards now from Millennium in their own jungle around this blue buff. Also in the mid lane, so they can see Super Crew keeping Mr. Riles in the mid lane. And some members going down to this bottom lane. So at least for now, they know where Super Crew is moving. They can see all five members coming down to this bot lane as well. What they can do about it, I'm not too sure.
Well, Elastic Slingshot is available still off the side. They have to back away the threat of Mimer being there while they take down this top inner turret. Outer turret, sorry. It's going to be a trade. I'm not too sure in it for outer, but it's anything that right now for Millennium can pick up, I think, is a goal.
Trading tower for tower. Inhibitor is still open, as you just said before, and Super Cruise has not been going for it. Just want to kill all the outer turrets first. Could walk in, take Inhibitor, go back to Baron, then set up all the pink wards. And therefore, we already have the super minions pushing into the base, but it seems like they maybe just want to set up the Baron, get it, and then move in towards the base of Millennium here. Still about 10,000 gold in favor of Super Hot Crew. So if we can go back and see how much gold he actually has. 1,400 at the moment. Should be able to get a Void Staff if he wants it.
Well, now the threat of Baron is on. Kasing wipes out the wards and Millennium try to shuffle on in there and get themselves some vision. Jiri's going to clear out this pink. Oh, just about. With the help of the curb. They have to start looking across the lanes. You can see bottom wave is going to shove itself in. Mid wave, Mr. Rales is shoving in. Kasing's keeping everything swept and clean around the Baron pit while the rest of the team keep them busy. They've got to be aware that there is a very fed AD carry shoving minions in towards their inhibitor. And they're slowly but surely being bullied out of this jungle, their own jungle. They're not able to keep hold of it. Red buff spawns. That's going to be the target area. Does anyone want to waste their smite on it while the Baron is being started? I don't think so. Cortnex is going to try and hold on to this one. They're trying to just draw him and say, come on, use it.
Not there is a scrying orb for Kraithon, though. He can use it to see if anything is going on.
He could do with using it because at the moment, Super Hot Crew keeps them busy. There's the Baron gone. And hello, we have Baron, guys. Elastic Slingshot not going to be used. It was charged up, but Millennium back away.
It's honestly been Super Hot Crew's jungle pretty much the entire game long. They've just been going into the jungle of Millennium, warded up, and make sure Millennium couldn't do anything other than just sit around the mid lane or their own base. So just an easy Baron pick up here, and now this inhibitor should be the target. Get the super minion spawning, and then you can focus on the side lanes. Millennium, while they did try and change the playstyle, they go for more teamfight focus. The lane swap was just as terrible for them, and once again did the same mistake they did in game one. Didn't back away from the tower, ended up dying for it. Lose the tower eventually later on in the game anyway, because it was so low.
It's quite clear what the target is. It's an exposed inhibitor, and Mr. Rallard's getting the free shots on it once again. Sidesteps Cotton X. Oh, let's bounce going down. Jumping on towards him, and just like that, Kerb is taken off the map. Jiree pops the ultimate. Nobody's really caring about that one. Impaler will catch on towards him. That's himself a kill. 3-for-1. Super Hawk Crew look to be taking this one solidly. Will they try and tank this one out to finish? It seems Kasing's happy to. Mr. Rallis will get the free attacks. One Nexus turret down. Minions coming in towards it. Super Hawk Crew looking solid. They're going to tie themselves up that fifth place spot, and it's Millennium that will be forced down into the relegation zone. They're going to be playing in the spring promotion tournament. Fantastic result, honestly, for Super Hawk Crew. A team that looked down and out last week have taken victory here against Millennium.
And just very, very smart to force the lane swap again. Take advantage of Millennium being weak there, get the early lead, and credit to Super Hawk Crew for really fixing the weak pick and ban phase they had against SK Gaming, or against Rocket, sorry. We saw some new picks coming out for them. And Millennium just clearly were completely outclassed. Like, again, pick and ban wise, just in this game where, you know, early picking the Alistar, ended up doing nothing, ended up picking the Shen into Zac anyway, which was a losing matchup for them, or at least a matchup where Kevin couldn't do anything against Mimer. They were just outclassed on the map, in team fights, in lane swaps. Subaku were the better team, that's why they win all the games, and why they stay in the LCS now.
It is indeed. It's a gratifying result for them. Team that did very well throughout the season, finished now in third place overall. Yeah. But just didn't turn up against Rocket. They managed to finally do what counts, and we'll see them, of course, back in the spring of 2015 in the LCS.
So it means a nice and long break now.
Yes.
For the Super Crew. Of course, you wanted to be at Worlds, but now they can just sit and watch Worlds, try and learn something for whatever teams are playing, pick up some stuff, and then use it when LCS actually starts next season, because they are still a very young team, so now they have a lot of time now to practice and prepare for the next season.
And they can take a well-earned break, because if you remember, they came in 2 days before spring 2014 season began. They were last-minute replacements coming in there for the Lemon Dogs. They managed to get themselves in. They've held on through relegation in the summer, and now got themselves back in towards the LCS. So we'll see how it works out for them. For Millennium, though, they now have the choice of opponents. Not something they really wanted to get.
No.
But they have to pick one of those three challenger teams. Strong, strong teams. H2K, they finished number one. Are they the number one seed? Well, that's up to Millennium. Of course, alongside MSK Prime, they went 3-2 in that final. And Unicorns of Love, who just obliterated their opponents 3-0 and looked very, very solid.
And just looking at the playoff here, Millennium has lost every single game they played. Mm. Didn't win any games against SK Gaming now. Super Crew as well. Destroyed them.
And before the Super Week, they are on a hell of a
They lost a lot of games in a row. It seems like for Millennium,
4.13 has not been good to them so far.
No, just went completely downhill for them. Kerb tried to play Orianna here in the last game. I haven't seen him play it before. Had little to no impact in the game, which can be said about the rest of the members, of course, as well. From Millennium, it's not one guy you're blaming here. The entire team were underperforming. So they've just been losing so many games in a row. Now you have to get your confidence back going into the promotion tournament and feel like, okay, we are still the LCS team. We are the stronger ones. We are the ones who are supposed to win this matchup here and get back into the LCS. But after losing so many games, it can be very hard. Well,